Hey guys, this is Abhishek from GadgetStudio.com, and today we are going to do a hands-on preview of the HTC Desire 700 device. Here we have the device with us, and this device has been launched in India. It has been launched for a price of around approximately 33,000 Indian rupees, which is kind of high, but in terms of the specification, this device is good. So if we talk about the specification of this device, it has got a 1.2 GHz quad-core processor, and when it comes to the thickness, this device is around 10.3 mm in terms of the overall thickness. Not a very thin phone, but looks pretty good. The back cover is again removable on this phone, and it has got a matte finish with a rubberized feel to it, and it definitely looks good. As far as the back camera is concerned, you have an 8 megapixel camera at the back with LED flash, and it does have the backside illuminated sensor as well. In terms of the weight, this device weighs around 149 grams in terms of the overall weight, so it does not feel very heavy. The display size on this device is a 5 inch, so this is one of the biggest display phone which you can actually buy from HTC as of now. When it comes to the display resolution is not that great. The display resolution is a QHD resolution which we get on this device. It is a 540 into 960 pixels display resolution which you will get, and you get around 220 pixels per inch. And if you actually take a closer look over this display, the display is good, but you won't feel any kind of pixelation. However, the resolution is low on this 5-inch display, but you won't notice the pixelation of the text even with naked eyes or with the cameras. So when it comes to other specification, it has got HTC Boom Sound. You have dual loudspeakers, as you can see over here. It has followed almost the same design principle which we have seen on HTC One. So in terms of the design, it is pretty good. The battery on this device is a 2100 mAh battery, and when it comes to display, it is a 5-inch display device. The back camera is 8 megapixel, whereas the front camera is... So the front camera on this device, let me just confirm that for you. So the front camera on this device is a 2.1 megapixel camera, which is also capable of doing a high definition video recording and a video chat. When it comes to the back camera is capable of shooting videos at 1080p at 30 frames per second. When it comes to the focus, you do have autofocus functionality supported at the back camera. You do have geotagging and touch to focus mode also supported. When it comes to the processor, you have 1.2 GHz processor. And when it comes to the hardware, we are not sure about which hardware chipset it has. It might be MediaTek, it might be something else. It could be Qualcomm as well, but we cannot confirm you as of now as far as the specification of the chipset is concerned. When we talk about other specifications, you do have HTC Zoe mode as also supported within the camera UI of this phone, and again it is running the latest version of HTC Sense UI, that is HTC Sense 5.0. and one more thing which is good about this device is it is a dual SIM phone, and it does support the dual active and dual standby both. So the SIM card on this device is going to be dual active and dual standby. And another good thing is that it can support the CDMA as well as the GSM SIM card. So both the SIM cards can be supported in the dual SIM mode on this phone, which is definitely a very good thing. And it is dual active standby, so you do have dual active as well as dual standby on this device. You have a micro SD memory card slot over here to expand the storage of the device. The battery over here is a 2100 mAh battery, and again the back cover can be changed. However, you do not have NFC on the back cover. That is something which we can tell you as of now, but we can't confirm this as of now because we are not sure about the exact specification. This is a demo unit which we have with us. The final unit might have NFC. When it comes to the weight, it is 149 gram in terms of the overall weight. Again, slightly heavier as compared to the other phones which we have seen in the 5-inch display size, but still it is pretty good, not very heavy at all in terms of the weight. If we talk about the version of Android this device is running, let me show you the version of Android. So when we go to the about phone and if we check out the software version, this device is running Android 4.1.2 Jelly Bean out of the box. When we take a look over the storage scenario over here, let me just show you the storage as well. So under storage, it has 8 GB of internal memory, and out of which around 3.37 is being used and rest of it is available. So you have around 4.63 GB available to the user, which is again fairly good. And you also have the option of installing applications directly on the SD card, and that is something which HTC claims. So that means you can actually install applications from the SD card as well. And when it comes to the RAM, you have 1 GB of RAM on this device, and out of 1 GB of RAM, let me just show you the scenario. So 387 MB or 374 MB of RAM is being used, whereas rest of it is actually free. So you get slightly good amount of RAM free, around 400 to 500 MB of RAM free on this device in case you want to install more applications and other games. When it comes to the display is a capacitive touchscreen display. We can't confirm that it is TFT display, but again it looks like an IPS panel, as the viewing angles looks pretty good on this device. If you view the screen from extreme viewing angles, you can actually see what is happening on the screen from extreme viewing angles. So it looks like an IPS panel, but we can't confirm that as of now. But apart from this, if you talk about other specification, it will accept two SIM cards. Both of them should be a micro SIM, not a normal size SIM card. So when it comes to the HTC Sense UI, which is running, it is 5.0. You have Blink Feed, you have HTC Zoe mode supported. Let me just give you an idea about the camera UI. So this is how the camera UI looks like. And again, let me just take a photo as of now. So the back camera on this device is an 8 megapixel camera, and you also get the 8 megapixel camera in the HTC Desire 501, which is part of this series as well, and that one is the most affordable available for a 16,000 rupees price point, whereas this one has 8 megapixel camera, and the camera quality on both of these devices is almost the same. We have just taken this photo, and this photo comes out to be pretty good in terms of colors. However, in terms of details, it is not that good, but again the daylight performance of the camera is really good. We have just taken some other shots as well, and the daylight performance of the camera is definitely good. You do have the option of recording a high definition video from the back camera. You can record a full high definition video at 1080p as well as at 720p. And let me just show you the setting for the camera as well. So once you go over here and check out the setting for the camera, you do have HDR mode supported, sweep panorama is also supported, you have anti-shake mode as well. And when it comes to the photo settings, let me just go to the video mode. So once we go to the video mode and we check out the photo settings, so it is right now recording as of now. If I check the video settings as of now, so you do have video quality, that is QHD HD, so you can record video at 1080p as well as at 720p, both at 30 frames per second. Which it comes to the phone dialer does not have the option of making a video call. When it comes to the messaging application is again optimized. It is the HTC Sense UI, which is running on top of Android, so the messaging application is good. Although the keyboard keys are pretty big in size, however they are not very nicely spaced from each other, so you might face some problem while typing on this device initially. But when it comes to continuous typing, you do not have that supported on this device. That is something which we can tell you as of now. You can send the message either from the SIM card 1 or from the SIM card 2. And one thing which is really good about this device is that it supports two kind of SIM card, that is it will support the GSM SIM card as well as the CDM SIM card, whereas the HTC Desire 601 and 501 will not support the two different kind of SIM card which this device actually supports. When it comes to the browser, this is how the browser will look like, and again the browser is kind of the same which we have seen with the HTC Sense UI. So in terms of the browser interface, these are some applications which will come pre-installed. You get all the standard applications with this device, including the CARM application, the media application, Google pre-installed application, and there are some tools. However, we do not see any specific games which will come pre-installed. You get all the standard list of application which you see on HTC Sense UI. And again, this UI on the device, as far as gallery is concerned, is kind of dynamic in nature, so it will give you that as well. So in terms of the overall value for money device, I would say it may not be the best value for money device as of now in the market, but in terms of the specifications and some kind of features like HTC Dual, like it has the dual SIM active and dual SIM standby supported, you can actually make two different kind of SIM card work on this device, including the CDMA SIM card as well as the GSM SIM card. Both of these SIM cards will work on this device without any issues. As far as camera is concerned, the camera on this device is an 8 megapixel camera, which is looking good in terms of the overall performance, and we will let you know more once we do the full review of this device. And as far as the resolution is concerned, the resolution is kind of low on this 5-inch display, but you do not feel the same because the pixel density is pretty good, and you do not notice pixels on this device unless you read document which has large number of text inside. So in terms of the overall specification, this device really looks very good, quite promising in terms of the value for money, and in terms of the overall form factor, this device is good as well. So being a 5-inch display device, you can easily hold this device in one hand. One thing which I do not like much about this device is that it feels slightly heavier in hand, so you will feel the weight once you hold the device in one hand. That is something which we can tell you. Apart from that, this device looks very good in terms of the overall value for money. It is going to be available for a price of around 33,000 approximately, or the exact price of this device is going to be, let me just tell you the exact price of this device is the exact price of the device is 33,050 rupees, which is the market operating price, and it is going to be available by 25th of December or the Christmas season around. So you can have this device available in the market. Apart from this device, the other dual active dual standby device which is launched from HTC today is HTC Desire 501, which is also a dual SIM device, and it is going to be available at the same time as this device is going to be available, that is 25th of December, around the 5th season. So that's all from us as far as the quick hands-on review of the HTC Desire 700. We really like this device and we would like to give a thumbs up to this device. In terms of the value for money device, it may not be the best value for money device, but it is quite promising and it does have some kind of features which you may not see in any other 5-inch Android phones out there. So do let us know if you have any specific questions for this device. We would love to help you. You can like this video help you by clicking the like button below. You can subscribe to our YouTube video channel for more videos like this by clicking the subscribe button below. Thanks for watching this video. This is Abhishek signing off. Thank you.